The Swift Algorithms package has a ton of useful algorithms that were optimized for performance by Apple. Today, we're doing a deep dive into one of these algorithms to show you how to use them, how to dig through the documentation so you can learn how to use any of these that might be useful for your project. In this example, I'm going to show you how I use the chunked algorithm to take a long list of expenses in my app and group them by month so I have this nice and organized UI that you see here. Today's video is sponsored by Squarespace. Here I am in Xcode, and as you can see on my canvas, I have this list of expenses. This is what we're gonna group by month to get this nice UI that you see here. Okay, let's review this starter project real quick. So mock data, first of all, I have my expense object, which you can see just has like a date, title, value. And then the mock data just creates 8 of these expenses. And I'm making sure I have different dates by adding 14 days to each date consecutively, as you can see here, to ensure, back to my content view, that I have expenses in various months. You can see July, August, September, October, November. And speaking of that list, as you can see here, it's a basic list that goes through those expenses, and each cell is an HStack that has the date, the title, and the value. So pretty straightforward SwiftUI. So like I said, we want to take this list of expenses and group them by month. And for that, we're going to use the chunked algorithm. So to use Swift algorithms, we have to install the package. So let's check out that Swift package in GitHub. So I will link to this in the description, but as you can see, it's from Apple, Swift algorithms. And you can see the README has a list of all the algorithms you see here. So this is like an overview, a summary. You can do a little shopping, see if any of these sound interesting for your project. But what I want to point out, if you go up to the top and hit guides, because the documentation is really good for all these algorithms. Like I said, we're going to focus on chunked, but you can apply this template, this blueprint on how I went about learning it and apply it to any of these other ones, again, that are useful for your project. So I'm in the guides folder, and now I want to go to chunked. And now you can see there's a couple different variations of chunked, chunked by, chunked on, chunks of count, and you get the explanation of what each one does. You get a little code example, and then the comment is what would print out. So for example, this is what we're gonna use in our app. We're gonna use chunked by. Uses a binary predicate to test consecutive elements. Essentially what it does is as it iterates through the array, it's going to check each element against each other for whatever predicate you pass in. And if I'm using buzzwords like predicate, you don't know what that means. Essentially that's this right here. This has to equate to a Boolean. So is $0 less than or equal to $1? And if you're not familiar with this dollar sign syntax, essentially that is each element in the array as it iterates through. So for example, $0 will be the first element in the array, $1 will be the second element in the array, and that will like slowly compare each one. So as long as this equates to whatever Boolean condition you passed in, then it will put it in a chunk. And then the first time it finds the next element that this doesn't pass the predicate you passed in, then it starts a new chunk. So this brings up the point with chunk specifically, your array needs to be in order, going back to Xcode, right? You can see my dates are in order. So it's gonna go through, here's July. And my predicate was gonna be make sure they're in the same month. We'll write that code in a second. But hey, July and August are not the same month. So it's gonna start a new chunk. And then on August 24th, well, that is in the same month. So we're still in the same chunk. And then September is different, so we're gonna start a new chunk. So you can see why the order matters. So you wanna sort by whatever you're gonna chunk on, because let's say my dates were all mixed up and I had a July as the first element and then a July as like the last element. Well, it would still break July into chunks. I would just have 2 July chunks, right? And I want them all chunked into one. So I'm saying chunked a lot. The point is, if you're using chunked, make sure your array is in order based on whatever you're chunking off of. So I'm chunking by dates, so I wanna sort by date. Let's say I wanted to chunk by name. Right now they're all named expense, but what if one was like health insurance or some other expense? I could chunk based on the name of the expense, so I got all my health insurance expenses for each month. I would sort alphabetically by expense name so that I made sure I got the chunks right. And you can see this back in the documentation because it says test consecutive elements. You'll see that everywhere through all these chunks, right? Projection of 2 consecutive elements is not equal. Because like I said, it is just comparing them as it goes through the array. But as you can see, you get chunked on, chunks of count. So maybe you just want a specific, hey, give me every 3 elements. I don't care what they are. Just go by 3 and put them in a separate array. That would be chunks of count. You can chunked on, right? You can see chunked on is by the first in the array. So that would be D for David, K for Kyle, K for Carol. So you can see you're getting D, David. For the Ks, you get 2 of them. So again, chunked is a way to group one big array into small subarrays or array slices more specifically, to use however you like. But the whole point I'm going through this is to show you how detailed the documentation is with the examples. And also you're getting the detailed design. So you wanna see what the code does under the hood. Again, Swift algorithms is open source. You can see that. So here's the detailed design with some explanations showing you how all this works. Again, more explanations. You want the complexity of the algorithms? Well, the eager ones are O of n, which is linear time, and then the lazy methods are O of one, which is constant time. I just wanted to point out how good the documentation is. Again, if I go back to the main page, you can see the whole list of the algorithms and what they do. So definitely check it out, do some shopping, see what's useful to your project, dive in and learn them. All right, let's install the package and implement chunked. So back to Xcode, we want to do file, add packages. And here we are right at the top, Swift algorithms. Go ahead and add that package. Hit add package. There we go. Now I'm going to do this in my mock data. Wherever you do the calculation for chunked is going to be specific to your project. When I use chunk to sort my expenses, I do it when I make the fetch to core data and get all my expense items back. Then I do the chunking there. Again, for this video, I'm going to do it in my mock data, but where you do it is going to be dependent on your project. So again, I have mock data with my array of expenses. So we're going to create another static var computed property here called chunked expenses. And this returns an array of arrays. And that's going to be an array of expense arrays, right? Because each month, right? July is going to be an array of the July expenses. August is going to be an array of the August expenses. But again, I want to point out, and we'll see this in the code, that, hold on, let me return an empty array here so Xcode stops yelling at me. Remember I said chunked returns an array slice. And if I go back to the documentation on this, again, documentation is great. Go to guides, chunked. You can see here in the code here, it returns a subsequence. And the reason it returns a subsequence or an array slice is for performance reasons. And I'm not gonna pretend that I'm some algorithm optimization expert. I'll take Apple's word for it. And they do go into the details in the WWDC session that introduced Swift algorithms. So I'll put a link to that in the description as well if you wanna watch that, if you do wanna dive deeper. Okay, back to Xcode. What I wanna do is I wanna take this expense array up here that has all my expenses, and I wanna chunk this so I create a bunch of array slices based on the month. So I will say let chunked expenses equal mock data dot expenses. And that's just this array right here. That is all my 8 expenses. And again, dot chunked. Oh, I don't have, forgot to import algorithms. There we go. So now I should have chunked here. So expenses dot chunked. And then again, we're doing chunked by, and we can just give ourselves the closure here, the trailing closure syntax. If you're not familiar with trailing closure syntax, check out my video all about closures. It'll dive into that. So like I said, this is where we pass in the predicate. Like, what do we want to chunk by? And like I said, we want to make sure we create chunks based on the month. So again, July goes into its own array. August goes into its own array. So to do that, this is a little date magic here. So we do calendar. And by the way, this calendar would be calendar.current, but I've already created this calendar object here. So calendar.isDate, and you can see right here, is date one equal to, you pass in another date, and then a granularity level. So you can say, is this in the same year? Is this in the same month? Is this in the same day, same minute? So I don't know if it goes down a minute. I've never used that one. But anyway, this is what we want to use. So the date, the first date we want to pass in is $0. Remember, that's the first item throughout the iteration. Dot date equal to $1 dot date. So we're comparing, again, the first element in the array to the next element in the array, comparing those dates. And the granularity, day, era, hour, minute. I guess it does go down to the hour, minute, nanosecond. Wow, crazy. Anyway, we want month. So this will return true. So calendar, it reads nicely, right? Calendar is date, this first date equal to the second date to the granularity of a month. So are the months the same is really what that means. If it's true, we're gonna put that in its own chunk. If it's false, we're gonna move on and create a new chunk with the next date. And again, because our dates are in order, it's gonna chunk them nicely. Now, like I said, this chunked returns, let me go back to the documentation here on that. You can see it returns an array slice. Our list here on our UI only works with arrays. It doesn't work with an array slice. So we need to return this as an array. So back to our mock data, that's simple enough. So instead of returning an empty array, we're gonna return chunked expenses.map. And then the map basically transforms every element in the array. And what we want to do to every element in the array, and remember each element in this array is an array slice of expenses, right? It's each month. So it's an array of arrays. So I want to initialize each one of those arrays, which is the $0, as just a regular array. And that's what I'm returning. So that is why I'm returning an array of expense arrays. So this is Swift algorithms in play. Like, it does look like a long line of code. That's because our calendar math is a long line of code, but this, just put it on one line of code. And you can imagine if you had to group all of these by month, maybe you'd have a for loop and you'd be creating a bunch of arrays and sorting stuff. Or you could use like a dictionary maybe where you go through it and create a key value pair based on the month, and each month has multiple values, and then you make an array of those values. There's multiple different ways you can do it. Either way, it's much longer than one line of code. And Like I said, this algorithm has been built by Apple engineers or the community and heavily scrutinized before it got put in the package, and it's optimized for performance. I will take one line of code and Apple's optimization over anything I come up with all day, every day. So that's why I love Swift algorithms, but let's update our UI to make sure this is working and see it in action. So into our content view, well, our list is set up to only have one array of expenses, but I want to iterate over my array of arrays. So we'll do a for each instead of mock data expenses. We'll do mock data dot chunked expenses. And I need to do an ID here of dot self. That is because my actual expenses, you can see here, they are identifiable. They have an ID, so I don't need that parameter. My array of arrays needs that parameter. So that's why that happened there. So now instead of just a singular expense, this is expense is, because I'm iterating over an array of arrays. So now in each array, I want to have a disclosure group. Looking at the UI, that is what pulls up this little drop-down arrow that exposes it. Okay, so now within each exposure group, this is kind of like a nested for loop, I want to do for each data ID content. Basically have the same line of code I had before. So expenses, and then the ID. I actually don't need the ID because the expense is identifiable, like I just pointed out. And then the content, say expense. So now I'm in each subarray, right? I'm in each month iterating over each month. And for that month, I want to have this HDAC, which is just the list cell, essentially. I could refactor this view out and just call it expense cell and pass in an expense, but I kept all the code right here. The disclosure groups needs a label so it knows what to say. So for that, we're going to just have a text and I'm going to do expenses. So the plural version of expenses, remember, is the whole array of August, the whole array of September, or whatever that is. So expenses.first, I'm going to force unwrap that for now, dot date, and I'm going to do formatted, and then the date time format of month, and then you see the format I have in there, I can pass in wide. So wide will give me the full month name that you'll see pop up here. So again, this is like date formatting stuff. You pass in a date time, you can customize how the year looks, you can customize how the day looks, how the month looks. I only want month, and I only want it wide. Wide will give me the whole name. Getting a lot of like little date formatting and date calculation, little bonus lesson in this algorithms video. But you can see, that's why it pulls up July here, August, September, October. And within each one, I tap August. There it is, August expense 2 and 3. September, here's my September expenses. July only has one expense. So again, we took that original list back to the mock data, chunked it into array slices for each month, and then we converted each of those array slices to an actual array so we could use it in our UI. And then here we are, we iterated over that array of arrays for each subarray, which again is July, August, September, go through each of the expenses, create our cell, you know, with the date, the title, the value, and then the label for the disclosure group is, again, just the full month. That was an example of using chunked from Swift algorithms, but hopefully seeing that process, seeing me dive into the documentation, seeing the examples, seeing what all is there for you to look into, hopefully that gave you some guidance on how you can use any of these algorithms that would be useful for your project. And if you're here learning about algorithms to make your code more performant, you're probably making great apps. And a great place to showcase those apps is a portfolio website. And that brings me to today's sponsor, Squarespace. Squarespace is an all-in-one platform to help you get that iOS developer portfolio, blog, or personal website up and running very quickly. Now I know, we're all developers with the skills and the desire to build the web page ourselves, but I would argue there's an opportunity cost to your time. If you're an iOS developer trying to build a great product, a great app, maybe spending a lot of time learning the ins and outs of web development, responsive design, isn't the best way to spend your time. That's why I recommend Squarespace to build that personal website, the blog, your portfolio, or maybe a landing page for your app. They have all kinds of beautiful themes and templates to get you started. They handle all the analytics and the SEO for you. Again, it just saves you so much time so you can get back to doing what you want to do, and that is building iOS apps. So when you're ready to get started, go to squarespace.com to start your free trial. And when you're ready to launch, go to squarespace.com/SeanAllen to get 10% off your first purchase of a website or domain.